Okay, so you survived up to lesson five. Well done. I'm proud of you for staying awake for so long. And soon it'll be over. I promise soon it'll be over. Listen, thanks for everyone who is liking and subscribing. What would help a lot is share. Share with all of the people that you think are going to benefit from this. Under the YouTube new policy, I need 1,000 subscribers and need to get this somehow. So please share it with anyone who you think will benefit from it. Please like, please subscribe, please comment. It's lovely to hear your comments, and again, makes it all worthwhile. So let's kick in. Under 4.34, we are expected to understand and know general metrological requirements and restrictions. So under 434.2, we need to be able to state the Met minimas for VFR flight A or H in various airspaces under CAR 91. And under CAR 91, 301, we come to the VFR metrological minimas. And it says, except as provided in Rule 91303 and paragraphs B and C, a pilot in command must not operate an aircraft under VFR A, or sorry, 1, when the flight visibility is less than that prescribed for the corresponding class of airspace in Table 4, or 2, at a distance from clouds that is less than that prescribed for the corresponding class of airspace in Table 4. And you can find these Met minimas, obviously, in your AIP. So the way that this breaks down, nice easy way to remember it, is that B, you have to be clear of cloud, and the flight visibility has to be 8K at or above 10,000 feet AMSL. In class C, D, and E, you need to have 2K horizontal separation and 1,000 feet vertical outside of a control zone and 500 feet vertically within a control zone. And that's, again, same thing, 8K at or above 10,000 AMSL and 5K below 10,000 feet AMSL. For F and G, needs to be above 3,000 feet above mean sea level or 1,000 feet above terrain, whichever is the higher. You need 2Ks of horizontal and 1,000 feet vertical, and the flight visibility is the same, 8K at or above 10,000 feet and 5K below 10,000 feet. And G sits there, is the at or below 3,000 feet AMSL or 1,000 feet above the terrain, and above 3,000 feet AMSL or 1,000 feet above the terrain. You need to be clear of cloud and in sight of the surface, and flight visibility is 5K. So there's the separation. I'm sorry how the chart works out, but it's kind of like the easiest way to sit there. So B, clear of cloud, 8K or above 10,000 feet, or 5K below 10,000 feet. In C, D, and E, same flight visibility, but 2K horizontal and 1,000 feet vertical outside of a control zone, 500 feet vertical within a control zone. And then F and G kind of wrap up around the anything above 3,000 feet, 2K and 1,000 feet vertical, and at or below 3,000 feet, or 1,000 feet above the terrain, whichever is the higher, you need to be clear of clouds and inside of the surface. Cloud? That's not right. Cloud. That must be a Freudian slip. And flight visibility, 5K. Again, sorry about the layout, but it's the easiest way to be able to sort of show that out. So, B, except as provided in Rule 91303, a pilot in command must not take off or land an aircraft or fly in the vicinity of an aerodrome under VFR when the flight visibility or the cloud ceiling is less than 1, at aerodromes within a control zone that prescribed in Table 5, that you can see there, and 2, at aerodromes in an uncontrolled airspace that is prescribed in Table 6, which you can also see there. So, Table 5 is all aircraft, day or night, you've got a 1,500 feet ceiling and flight visibility of 5K. And that's the VFR minimums at aerodromes within a control zone. So C, B, and F as well. VFR minimums at aerodromes in uncontrolled airspaces, so Class G airspace. All aircraft day, you have a ceiling of 600 feet and flight visibility of 1500. And at night, all aircraft 1500 feet, ceiling 8K flight visibility. That one, a lot easier to understand. C, a pilot in command of 1, a helicopter may operate in Class G airspace with flight visibility of less than 5K if manoeuvred at speed that gives adequate opportunity to observe other traffic or any obstructions in order to avoid collisions. And an aircraft performing agricultural aircraft operations may operate in Class G airspace, and that's only G airspace, with a flight visibility of less than 5K but not less than 1500 meters. And 3, an aircraft performing flight instruction may operate within a designated low fly zone prescribed under Part 71 with flight visibility of less than 5K but not less than 1500 meters. So, what that means, demystified, is for operations in different airspaces, use the minimum visibility and distance from cloud in this table. When taking off, landing, or operating in the vicinity of an aerodrome, the visibility and cloud ceilings required is either in Table 5 for control zones. There are 3 exceptions to the ceiling and the visibility requirement. Helicopters in uncontrolled Class G airspace can fly in visibility less than 5K. Ag aircraft can fly in visibility less than 5K, but has to be more than 1500 meters, and when being instructed you may operate in a low fly zone with visibility less than 5K but has to be more than 1500 meters. I'm going to say that again just one more time. For operating in different airspaces we use this table, and that table breaks down to: when taking off and landing or operating in the vicinity of an aerodrome, the visibility and cloud ceiling required is either within a control zone, day or night, 1500 feet ceiling, visibility of 5K. And in an uncontrolled airspace, day is 600 feet ceiling, flight visibility 1500 meters. Night, 1500 feet and ceiling and flight visibility of 8K. Now, you know that you're going to get a question on the exam around this, and they are going to try and confuse you with the 1500 meters and the 1500 feet. So run this around your head a few times, okay? Read this, understand it, find your own way of being able to memorize it. I know it's painful. You'll probably only get 1, at worst 2 questions on this, but still, it's worth getting it nailed. So the 3 exceptions are: helicopters in uncontrolled can fly in visibility less than 5K, but it's based on the speed. Ag aircraft can fly in visibility less than 5K, but it has to be more than 1500 meters. And you can operate under instruction in a low fly zone with visibility less than 5K, but it has to be more than 1500 meters. Right, special VFR weather minimums. A pilot in command of an aircraft may perform a VFR operation within controlled airspace in meteorological conditions below those prescribed in 91301 if the ceiling and the flight visibility is at least 600 feet and at least 1500 meters respectively. For helicopters, less than 600 feet and less than 1500 meters. Respectively, if the helicopter is operated at a speed that will give adequate opportunity to observe traffic or any obstructions in order to avoid a collision. The aircraft is equipped with a two-way radio capable of communicating with ATC on the appropriate frequency, and the operation is conducted 1, in compliance with ATC clearance and ATC instructions, and 2, only during the day, and 3, clear of cloud. So, meaning you are able to operate in meteorological conditions less than that previous table 4 and 5, when you are within controlled airspace only when you are operating under special VFR. And under special VFR, you must still have a ceiling of 600 feet and visibility of 1,500 metres, other than helicopters who can get away with a lot more, bless them. But anything above 600 metres, they start getting nosebleeds anyway, so all your fixed wing guys are fine. The following restrictions apply. You must comply with ATC clearances and instructions. The aircraft must have two-way radio communication capable of communicating primarily with ATC. And this can only be during the day, and you must still remain clear of cloud. Easy. What do you remember? So, one, meteorological minimum minima apply when you are flying in uncontrolled airspace below 3,000 feet AMSL or 1,000 feet above the terrain, whichever is higher. A, distance from cloud must be 2K horizontally, 1,000 foot vertically, and with 5K visibility. B, distance from cloud must be 2K horizontally, 1,000 feet vertically, with at least 8K visibility. C, clear of cloud and inside of the surface with at least 5K visibility. Or D, clear of cloud and inside of the surface with at least 8K visibility. And you're going to see these on the exam, so let's read the question again. What meteorological minima apply when you are flying in uncontrolled airspace below 3,000 feet AMSL or 1,000 feet above the terrain, whichever is higher? Now, we read that twice. We know what the answer is. Let's go. Pick your choice. And yes, it's C. Clear of cloud and inside of the surface within at least 5K visibility. So the full part here. At or below 3,000 feet above mean sea level or 1,000 foot above the terrain, whichever is the higher. Clear of cloud and in sight of the surface with 5K visibility. What's the meteorological minima apply when you are flying in uncontrolled airspace above 3,000 feet AMSL or 1,000 feet above the terrain, whichever is the higher, but below 10,000 feet AMSL? A, distance from cloud must be 2K horizontally, 1,000 feet vertically with at least 5K visibility. B, distance from cloud must be 2K horizontally and 1,000 feet vertically with at least 8K visibility. Clear of cloud and in sight of surface with at least 5 kilometers visibility. Or clear of cloud and inside of the surface with at least 8 kilometers visibility. Quick reread of the question. We're still talking about uncontrolled airspace. But this time we're talking about above 3,000 feet above mean sea level or 1,000 feet above the terrain, whichever's the higher, but below 10,000 feet above mean sea level. Make your choice, take your chance. And it's A. Distance from the cloud must be 2K horizontally and 1,000 feet vertically with at least 5 kilometers of visibility. And there it is. And this applies to F and G airspace. Again, you're going to have to find some way of being able to put these together. You can repeat it parrot fashion. I don't know the best way that you remember these things. For me, it was just going over it and over it and over it again. Next, what meteorological minima apply when you are flying in a control zone? A, distance from cloud must be 2K horizontally, 1,000 feet vertically with at least 5 kilometers visibility. B, distance from the cloud must be 2 kilometers horizontally and 1,000 feet vertically with 8 kilometers of visibility. C, distance from the cloud must be 2 kilometers horizontally, 500 feet vertically with at least 5 kilometers visibility. Or distance from the cloud must be 2 kilometers horizontally, 500 feet vertically with at least 8 kilometers of visibility. Pay your money, take a chance. And it's C. Distance from the cloud must be 2K horizontally, 500 feet vertically with at least 5K of visibility. 2K horizontally, 1,000 feet vertically outside of the control zone, 500 feet vertically within the control zone. Okay. What meteorological minima apply when you are flying at an aerodrome in a control zone during the day or night? Ceiling has to be 600 feet, visibility 1,500 meters. B, ceiling of 1,500 feet, visibility of 1,500 meters. C, ceiling of 1,000 feet, visibility of 5K. D, ceiling of 1,500 feet, visibility of 8K. You see what I did there? These are the horrible, horrible questions that you get on the exam. It is C, ceiling of 1,500 feet, visibility of 5K. All aircraft, day or night, within an aerodrome, within the control zone for that aerodrome. What meteorological minima apply when you are flying an aerodrome in uncontrolled airspace during the day? Uncontrolled airspace during the day. Ceiling 600 feet, visibility 1500 meters. Ceiling 1500 feet, visibility 1500 meters. Ceiling 1500 feet, visibility 5 kilometers. Ceiling 1500 feet, visibility 8 kilometers. Now, for those of you with a photographic memory, that's just going to ruin it for you. It's no fun. It is A, ceiling of 600 feet, visibility of 1,500 feet, 1,500 metres. Oh, God, shoot me now. Meteorological minima apply when you are flying at an aerodrome in uncontrolled airspace during the night. Ceiling, 600 feet, visibility 5K. Ceiling, 600 feet, visibility 1,500 metres. Ceiling, 1,500 feet, visibility 5K. Ceiling 1,500 feet, visibility 8K. Pick 3, 2, 1, and it's D. Ceiling 1,500 feet, visibility 8K. We'll go back there. It is at night. It is uncontrolled airspace. There's the table. What is special VFR, meteorological minima? A, 600 feet, visibility 5K. Ceiling 600 feet, visibility 1,500 metres. Ceiling of 1,500 feet, visibility of 5K. D, ceiling of 1,500 feet, visibility of 8K. B, ceiling of 600 feet, visibility 1,500 metres. You are able to operate in meteorological conditions less than in those two tables when you are within controlled airspace only. When you're operating under special VFR. Under special VFR, you must still have a ceiling of 600 feet and visibility of 1,500 metres. The following restrictions apply. You must comply with ATC clearances and instructions. The aircraft must have two-way radio capable of communicating with ATC. You can only do this during the day. You must still remain clear of clouds. Helicopters, I believe you only must do this during the day and you must still remain clear of clouds. And you must be able to talk to ATC. But the heights are slightly different for you guys. So, well done. I'm going to try and keep these a little bit more condensed because it stops me falling asleep halfway through this. So, remember, like, subscribe, please, please share. I got to get up to 1,000 subscribers and I need your help to do this. So tell everyone, tell the world, and even people who don't fly, get them flying. Because they can share the misery of having to do this exam with you. Thank you all for watching. Thanks for sticking by. Fly safe. And most importantly, keep enjoying what we do.